Logician's joke. Three logicians walk into a bar. The waitress asks, "Does everyone want beer?" The first logician, "I do not know." The second logician, "I do not know." The third logician, "Yes." The waitress writes down, "Logicians, three beers." So there is this parallel between beer jokes and heart puzzles. In beer jokes, each logician knows his wishes, but others do not. In heart puzzles, the assumption is that each person knows others' heart colors, but not his own. So have you ever heard about Langland's program? Today, I am announcing my own program. Find a way to convert hat puzzles into beer jokes. And beer jokes into hat puzzles. So I'm trying to use this joke and have a puzzle where all logicians give the same answers. Three logicians walk into a bar. For some reason, it doesn't fit, my screen doesn't fit here completely. So they know that I have hats from this set, like three red and two blue. Each one has one hat, but they know that the hats are from this set. So the waitress asks, "Do you know the color of your hat?" The first logician, "I do not know." The second logician, "I do not know." The third logician, "Yes." The question is, what is the color of the third man's hat? Okay. Someone said it. Red, explain.
You want me to explain?
Yes.
If he sees his two friends wearing blue hats, he thinks from that set he has a red hat.
What? So any other explanation? So the first logician, if he sees two blue hats, he has to say red, but he says he doesn't know, that means he doesn't see blue hats. After that, the second logician knows that the first logician cannot see blue hats. If he sees one hat, blue hat, that he would know that his hat must be red, because the second logician said, "I do not know," that means that the third logician must have the red hat. Okay, now I'm moving to hat puzzles, and it's up to you to convert them later into beer jokes. So I will start with an old famous puzzle. So the logicians stand in a line, all facing forward. The hats are either red or blue, and there is no limit, like an unlimited number of each color is available. So they only can see the hats in front of them, and they can speak, they can guess their colors in any order they want. They are not allowed any other information. They are not allowed to sneeze or do strange things. They only can say red or blue. And the goal is to minimize the number of logicians who are mistaken. So let's start with two people and two hats. So it is sort of clear that the last person doesn't have any information about hats, so he might be mistaken. So we are trying to minimize it to make it him the only one who is mistaken. So is there any way to, in this case, for one person to guarantee to guess their color? Anyone?
Say blue.
Explain. Yes, he can say the color of the hat of the guy in front of him. Okay, more complicated. Three people.
I know this one.
You know this one. Anyone else? Any suggestions?
Same or different?
Yes, the last guy signals same or different color. So he say red would mean same color. He say blue, it would mean different color. I usually give out this puzzle to my high school students, and they stop here. They figure out two or three hats and do not know what to do next. So suppose we have 100 hats. So what do we do now? Any suggestions?
Parity.
Parity, yes, great, parity. So the last person calculates the number of red hats and says if this number even or odd. And then starting from behind, everyone can calculate their number. So we can also say that red hats are 0, blue hats are 1. We can do it with numbers. But the next puzzle is many colors. Suppose we have 5 colors. What do we do? How many people might be mistaken? Any suggestions? Say it again. Modulo 5. So the answer is the last person summed the colors modulo 5. Oh, you know the colors are numbers. Who cares? Mathematicians all the same. So the last person summed the colors modulo 5. There are 5 colors and guesses. And this way everyone can, only one person is mistaken. So now I want to talk about a new puzzle which appeared in March 2013 at the Tournaments of the Towns. It was invented by Konstantin Knop and Alexander Shapovalov. So the puzzle is N logicians, N plus one hats of distinct colors. The logicians are not allowed to repeat their colors, and we want to minimize the number of mistakes. This is a very beautiful puzzle. So the problem is you cannot repeat your color. So do I have a minute?
No, you have 0 minutes.
I have 0 minutes. Submit your answers to me. The puzzle is very beautiful. The first solution people come up with is not the right one, and the right solution is better than the first natural solution. So thank you.